In this episode, I'm going to show you how to incorporate Photoshop's Generative Fill into your After Effects projects. With the explosion of artificial intelligence being incorporated into virtually every aspect of our lives, Adobe has begun to include this fascinating technology into its apps. As of the time of this tutorial, Generative Fill is only available in Photoshop's beta version, but it will no doubt become a standard tool that is used in the everyday lives of designers. Today, I'll be showing you how to expand images for use in After Effects, which is one very useful aspect of AI and will change the way we design altogether. We have a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. One of the things I commonly do at my day job is make animated quote cards for various uses on social media. And if you've ever done any work in social media, you'll know that there are a variety of sizes. The most common are 1x1, 9x16, and 16x9. So I'm just going to show you an example using this image of my beautiful wife, Sheila McKnight, and show you how Photoshop's Generative Fill literally changes what we can do with designing. If I make this a 1x1, this image fits for the most part okay. I'm going to pull up the actual image. As you can see, this is the whole image. So this is what we're limited with. There's no top of her head, there's no sides, and we can't go below this neckline right here. So we're very limited with what we can do with this image. Now it works for the most part on 1x1, but if we go to like 16x9, we can see that we lose the sides. Now one of the things you can do is Command Shift Option H, and it will fit your image to the width of your comp. But as you can see, we lose a lot of the image. We have to blow this up and it could get pixelated. And also we only have this much of her face to use. So this isn't very effective, but it's something I've had to do in the past because there were no other options. And if you go to 9x16, select the layer and Command Shift Option G, and it will fit the image to the height of your comp. While we can fit this in here, we don't have a whole lot to play with. We can't go above her head. We can't use the sides. One of the things that you may have done in the past is you could duplicate this layer, and then go over to your effects and presets and type in fast box, double click fast box blur, increase this bottom layer so it fits our comp, and then increase the fast box blur. And this is something that you may have seen online. With Photoshop's Generative Fill, we no longer have to do that. And this is something that's extremely powerful, and it is a very, very good use of artificial intelligence. So I'm gonna hop over here to Photoshop. And again, this is the beta version. So I'm gonna show you how we can expand this image. So the first thing we have to do is grab this cropping tool right here, click on that, and see we get this border around our image. What I do first is pull this border up, because first I wanna expand her head. Now grab your rectangle marquee tool right here, and we're going to draw a box around this transparent area and then include just a little bit of the image. You don't include too much because whatever's inside of this marquee tool is going to be changed by AI. So we're going to let go, and then we have this option for Generative Fill. I'm going to click that. You can type in something here if you want something added to this image. I don't. I just want to expand the image. So if you want to expand the image, all you have to do is simply click Generate. As we can see, this expanded her head. And this is actually a pretty good expansion. Notice over here in our properties panel, we have a few options. We have this first option, that's not bad. The second option looks pretty good as well. It's a different hairstyle. And then this last option here is a shorter forehead and her hair isn't quite right. So this looks a little bit distorted and you may get this. If you get a bad result, click on these three little dots here and actually just click poor result. This gives Photoshop some feedback and it lets it know if its results are accurate. So this middle version here, that's not too bad. So I may actually say it's a good result. And then this first one, this one's pretty good too, good result. I think it can do better. So I'm just going to click generate again, and you will get another three options. So this is the new first option. That one's really good. The second one is pretty good. Her head looks normal. Hair looks pretty good. And then this last version here, it's not bad, but the hairstyle isn't great. So I'm actually going to say it's a poor result. This one here, that's a good result. And then this one here is a great result, I think. See, I think I'm going to use this right here. Now let's grab our crop tool again and let's move this out to the left. And then again, we'll take our marquee tool, draw a box around this and include just the edge of our image. Generative Fill, generate. We're gonna let it run its algorithm and see what it comes back with. So this is kind of cool. It's added in this side over here. I'm not really gonna go into this, but I could actually choose this area over here and then change what I want that to be. For now, I just wanna show you what this can do for expanding images. Option two is a little bit different. And then option three, it looks like it puts something in the background, maybe like a dresser. So I actually like option three. So I'm going to say good result actually on all of these here because I think they all came out great. I'm going to take the crop tool again, expand out to the right, grab my rectangle marquee tool, and again, we're going to draw a box around the transparent area and include a little bit of the image, just a tiny bit, and generative fill, generate. And as you can see, this turned out great. Her arm looks pretty good. I like these lights over here. See the second option is a bit too abstract for what I'm going for. So I'm going to say that one's a bad result. And option three, that's pretty cool. It put us into a scene over here. It added in this table. I'll say good result just because I do like what it did over here. I'm going to generate again. AI's added something in here. I'm not sure what that is. It could work in certain contexts, but I'm not really going for like a horror kind of look. So I'm actually going to say that's a poor result. Second option right here, that's kind of cool. Her arm looks pretty normal, and I'm not sure exactly what that is, but it could work for our image. And then the last result, that one looks really good. So I'm actually going to go, I think, with this one right here. Okay, so I'm just going to go up to File. I'm going to go to Export, Export As, and I'm just going to export this as a quick JPEG. Now we can hop back over to After Effects. And now remember, if I go back over to our original shot, this is our original image. So I'm just going to open up my Finder, come over here and look for PS result, which is right here. Drag that in. And now if I double click that, we can see the difference between these two. So that's what we've added. This was our original. So as you can see, we have a lot more to work with. Let's go to our 16:9 layer right here. And I'm just going to drag in PS result, then Command Shift Option H to fit this to the width of our comp here. This looks so much better. We can actually make the image smaller to fit more of her body in here. So this has been very successful for the 16:9. Let's go to the 9:16, and again, we'll bring in this right here, and we're going to Command Shift Option G to fit our image to the height of our comp. Fit our original to the height of our comp, we can see just how limited we are. This is our new image here. We have a lot more to work with, and this looks great. So this new technology is absolutely amazing. It is going to change the way that we design. So I highly encourage you to embrace artificial intelligence and look into Photoshop's Generative Fill. As of the time of this tutorial, it's only in the beta version, so we know it will only get better. I hope this tutorial helped you out. Thanks for watching, and I will see you all next time. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.